It's not just me, right? Like all the time, brands are reminding you left something in your cart. I know, that's the point. Like it's sitting there because I'm really contemplating, do I need this? Should I spend money on it? I mean, eventually, I go back for a lot of it, but okay, here, this video today, okay? Another day, another coat, another Jerry look.
I surround my soul with the positivity. That's why I don't worry about the things that I don't see. Yeah. These days I don't worry about much. I think we should have some more fun. I still dream about the days when we were young. I'll take a hit and still.
What's going on, everybody? It's your girl TJ back. Another video talks with TJ, aka TJ2 Swoosh T Yeezy MA2 TJ. Thank you again so much for tuning in to another video. And weather is somewhat like trying to cool off, still trying to stay up in the 70s. I don't have time for that, okay? 60s, roll yourself on in here. My energy bill is still a little too high. So roll yourself on in here so that I can open my windows a little more. But with fall, that means, hey, we're breaking out jackets now. Funny enough, I've still styled looks with jackets even when it was 90 degrees outside. That's the beauty of having an in-home studio. It works for you that way. But it's jacket season. I love layering. I just think it's a great way to really bring an outfit together. A jacket makes everything better. I'm just gonna be honest with you. I could argue the same for a hoodie. So you guys know it's hoodie season, and ladies, it is still his hoodie season. Get on it, get information, secure you a few, you know. Do what you gotta do. Make sure you're warm this fall. Watch all the guys come for me in the comments. I'm gonna get attacked in the comments. It's okay. I'll take that heat for you girls. Go ahead. Go get your hoodie. But just with jackets, and you guys know, like I have a jacket obsession. Like I'm looking right now. My jackets have an entire like rung in my closet. It's pretty bad. But in terms of like overcoats, pea coats, or wool coats, I usually wear the H&M, like the lighter camel coat one. You guys see that worn a lot, and yes, it does have a lining in it. Now I think it's a 38 regular, so that doesn't really allow for me to put thicker hoodies underneath without it looking really bulky or me like not being able to freely move. You guys have been there before. If you put too many layers on, or they're too thick, or they don't have the right draping, it just doesn't work. So instead, definitely basing this on a Jerry look I saw, which, I mean, listen, he's just one to have that traditional wool coat, I guess, in his repertoire, whatever you would like to say. And then for the Met Gala, of course, where they had the museum set up for display, that was actually a look that was featured. And they went through a few different looks of how they maybe wanted to display their, I guess, their setup. So it still featured a coat, a hoodie. I think of it like a statement hoodie or something that's very monumental, because it was based on the Negro Leagues from his own mainline collection, which of course honors Negro Leagues for baseball. And then he had on sweats, and I believe they might have had on California as well. I don't have the Californias. I will probably one of these days. Don't have them right now, but it's not, in terms of the coat, H&M is another place I love to shop. Listen, it's affordable. It can usually get you through a few seasons, and I'm biding my time. I want a mainline coat that he puts out. Just right now, just spending that doesn't make sense when it could, like, that amount of money could just go towards a student loan or something. So that's why I can't justify it right now. But once those loans are done, I can justify that gift to myself. I just think if you have a higher quality item in your closet, you know, will last quite a long time, it's worth it. That's why some people will pay a great amount for a great pair of jeans or a denim jacket. So I think the coat is the same way. That's not where I am right now. So yes, I definitely went and got a cheaper alternative at H&M. Now there were a few items, or at least a few coats, I was kind of contemplating, but I just went with this darker brown one because I don't have any coats that are that color. And I think with some of the shoes I've picked up recently, whether it is the Social Status Nike Dunk, it could even be some other pairs that I have, I think having that darker brown play off of lighter tones, maybe in shoes, or maybe even darker tones, or just do something where it's all tonal, where a darker coat, maybe the amber essentials, and then maybe like some olive green kicks can really work together. I don't know. You guys will see them all thrown together here in the video of just me trying out different things with the coat itself. Now, this is a 40R or 40 regular. Just for reference, I am 5'6", like 130, 132. And I want to be able to put hoodies under here. I want to be able to wear the knit hoodies. And you guys know, I don't have all the knit hoodies in like my size. One of them is a medium, so it definitely fits a little bigger. And I want to be able to enjoy like wearing that with this actual coat. And it'll probably be worn with a lot of different essentials looks, but who knows? I could surely throw on something not essentials with it. Can be worn with Adidas, Jordan, Reebok, doesn't matter. So this is also available in black. I'll just put the link below. You guys can check it out. And I went up to a 40 regular because I want to be able to fit thicker hoodies, thicker sweaters, sweatshirts, doesn't matter. Underneath, had I gone with a 30, that may not have been possible. So it will have a little bit of that oversized look, but we all know I'll rock that anyway. So that's straight up in my wheelhouse right now. And as time goes on, I'll probably need to buy a different winter coat, like a parka with a hood, because it rains and snows a lot. Your girl has no time for that. And I might even get one that goes longer. Like for so long, people have said like, no, get a parka that goes like, you know, past your butt, because it's really nice when you have to walk around. And the fact that I have to walk my dog means, hey, I probably need to invest in that too. But new wool coat, I think it cost me $80? It might have been $80. I think it was $80, so nothing too crazy, right? Like cheaper than any pair of sneakers I'm normally gonna get. And it's something I can continuously wear throughout the fall. So go ahead, sound off. Do you guys like, is that part of what you rock in the fall? As soon as fall comes, you break out a wool coat, a pea coat, maybe depending on the climate you're in. If you're in Florida, California, I totally get you may never break one of these out or own them, and that's perfectly fine. But if you like what you saw, hit the subscribe button. If you're not subscribed, hit the like. I truly appreciate it. And as always, act your age, not your shoe size. Peace.